Hello everyone, and topic for today is DNA fingerprinting and GMO, that is genetically modified organisms. Subject is elements of biotechnology. Let's see first of all what is DNA fingerprinting. We all know what is DNA. DNA is a genetic material. Now we have 99.9% identical, all of the people, but of course there are unique because of 0.1% difference in the millions of people. These difference or polymorphism reside in several places in the genome, often in the microsatellite. Examples of such polymorphism include VNTRs, STRs, RFLPs and SNPs. DNA fingerprinting focuses on the 0.1% to 1% difference. That means that is the difference between the DNA that describes the unique person. First described in 1985 by Dr. Alec Jeffrey in England, DNA evidence is admissible in the courts. Labs such as Cellmark Diagnostics and Life Code Corporations are the examples of the companies which provide such DNA evidence to the courts. But states and many US cities have labs for DNA fingerprinting. It is usually used for parenting tests, means to detect who the father is or the mother is, for identification of the criminals, for example murderers, rapists, letter bombers, etc. Immigration disputes, means the family relationship, to identify the deceased individuals with the mutilated or decomposed bodies, for example military victims, etc. And identify the sperm donor who decorated the Monica Vinci's blue dress. How is DNA fingerprinting done? DNA is obtained from hair, semen, blood, sweat, saliva, bone or any other tissue. It can be done by sudden blotting with an approximate probe or by PCR method using an approximate primers. Cause can be single locus probe primers or multi locus probes or primers. DNA can be resolved on a gel by a capillary electrophoration. This is the figure how the DNA fingerprinting is done. Molecular diagnosis of genetic disease can also be done by fingerprinting, that is cystic fibrosis and sickle cell anemia can be detected. Now first of all, what is GM food? G means genetically modified or changing the gene. Genes, that is information of the cells that tell the cells what to do. We all know what DNA and gene does. Genetically modified organism is an organism whose genetic material has been altered using the genetic engineering technique or the RDT, recombinant DNA technology. GMOs are the source of the genetically modified food and are also widely used in the scientific research and to produce goods on other than food. GMOs are used in biological and medical research, production of pharmaceuticals, drugs, experimental medicines, example gene therapy and agriculture. Golden rice, resistance to herbicides. The term genetically modified organism does not always imply, but it can include the targeted insertions of the gene from one species into another. For example, a gene from the jellyfish encoding the fluorescent protein called GFP can be physically linked and thus co-expressed with the mammalian genes to identify the location of the protein encoded by the GFP tag gene in the mammalian cell. Such methods are used tool for biologists in many areas of research, including the one that study the mechanism of human and other diseases of the fundamental biological process in eukaryotic as well as prokaryotic cell. Now the genetically modified food, first of all BT brinjal. BT brinjal, that India's and the world's first genetically modified food crop, has been temporarily stopped in India thanks to the massive grassroots campaign. BT cotton, however, is being cultivated in many parts of India. Benefits are doubtful, though doubt exists about its productivity, and has been implicated with the negative effect like resistant test, high water consumption, farmer suicide, etc. What does BT stand for? BT stands for Bacillus thuringiensis, which is a natural soil bacteria which secretes a toxin that is deadly to two pests, that is fruit and shoot borer, FSB, that is this, and fruit borer, that is Helicordepa armigera. Eggplant borer, this is how it looks, and the second pest, this is what is harmed by Bacillus thuringiensis. What is genetic modification? Insertion of BT gene in the brinjal that is the genetic code, and the production of the BT toxin kill the pest. But it is only the genetic introduction. No, a promoter and the antibiotic resistant marker gene are also introduced. These are the advantages of BT cotton. Yield not shown to increase in BT cotton by or GM soy. Mycoy admits unable to control the pest in Gujarat with BT cotton. Increased use of pesticides and increased use of water for BT cotton. Disadvantages are it could lead to genetic contamination. Farmer suicide have doubled in BT cotton belt in Vidarbha. Monoculture will be wipe out the diversity, will make us dependent on the Montano for food. Now Dolly sheep, as we know, is the first cloned animal. What is Dolly? In 1997, Dolly sheep became the first vertebrate clone from the cell of an adult animal. Not only was this a remarkable scientific breakthrough, but it was immediately gained interest and the concern from the around the whole world on the future of the cloning technology as it would affect the humans. This is the Dolly sheep, was successfully cloned in Britain in 1966 by the scientist Ian Wilmot and was put down in February 2003 after developing a lung infection and arthritis. Dolly was the genetic copy of Finn Dorset Eve. Her birth more than 10 years ago showed that the nuclei from the specialized adult cell can be reprogrammed into the cell of an organism. This technique lead to the Dolly is called somatic nuclear transfer and has remained essentially unchanged over the last decade. What is cloning? Reproductive cloning. The entire animal is produced from a single cell by asexual reproduction. This would allow the creation of a human being who is genetically identical to another. And second is the therapeutic cloning. Broader the use of the term cloning does not create a new genetically identical individual. Research includes therapy for human mitochondria disease and others that could replace damaged or diseased tissues without the risk of rejecting another tissue, could create new skin tissue for burned patients. Methods of cloning are embryo splitting, artificially splitting a single embryo at the very early stage of development. In the natural process, this would create twins. However, because this is done at a very early stage and they are usually less than 8 cells, you can make only a few clones. Both the nuclear genes and the mitochondrial genes would be identical. Dolly in detail, Dolly was cloned using the nuclear replacement method. Again, the nucleus with the chromosome set is fused with the unfertilized egg of the nucleus was removed. Motivating factors that could help it to improve certain qualities in livestock. Dolly was not the first sheep to be created from the nuclear replacement. Two genetically identical sheep, that is Megan and Morgan, was born in the year 1996 using the same method. The difference was that Dolly was derived from an adult sheep and Megan and Morgan were derived from a sheep embryo. This is how the Dolly sheep is formed. First of all, the nucleus is taken and the sperms are taken, then the fertilization is done. The nucleus of the sperm cell is removed and then the fertilization is done, so a clone is formed of a single cell. Cells are taken from the 6-year-old Finnish Dorset Eve and cultured in a lab. 277 cells were fused with 277 unfertilized cells. 29 viable reconstructed eggs survived and were implanted in the surrogate back face Eve. One gave birth to Dolly. 0.361 chance of onset, 3.4482% once implanted in the nature, between 33% to 50% of the fertilized egg developed. Now, enucleated egg produced by the Scottish backface Eves treats with the Eve, that is the gonadotropin releasing hormone. We can also known as GnRH, to cause them to produce oocytes ready to be fertilized. Means the oocytes are ready to be fertilized by this hormone. Like all mammals, these are arrested in the metaphase of the second meiotic division, that is meiosis 2. Plunge a micropipette in the egg over the polar body and suck out the only polar body and put the haploid power within the egg. Fuse each enucleated egg with the diploid cell growing in the culture. Cells from the mammary glands of an adult finite Eve was grown into the tissue culture. 5 days before the use, the nutrient level of the culture is reduced and the cells stop dividing and enter the GO of the cell cycle. We know GO is one of the phase of the cell cycle. Donor cells and enucleated recipient cells are placed together in the culture, tissue culture that we have done. They are placed together and the culture are exposed to the pulse of the electricity to cause their respective of the plasma membrane to fuse, stimulate the resulting cell to begin the mitosis. Culture of the cells until they have grown into a morula or even into a blastocyst. Transfer several of these into the uterus of each of the Scottish Eves and treated with the GnRH, that is the hormone, to prepare them for the implantation. And then we wait till the result. One Eve gave birth to the only cloned sheep, that is Dolly. This is also one of the diagram that shows how the nucleus was removed and how the baby or the cloned sheep was formed. This is the diagram of the Dolly with her foster mother. So this is how the tissue culture of the udder cells and the egg cells both were done, and then the nucleus of one of the cell was removed, then the zygote or the fertilization was done and the clone was formed. How do we know that Dolly is not the progeny of the unsuspected mating of the foster mother? That is a question. She has a white face and the foster mother is a Scottish black face. DNA fingerprinting reveals that the bands found in the Finnish Dorset sheep that the breed with the supplied of the mammary cells are not of the Scottish black face sheep. They were different. So what about the Dolly's mitochondria? Although her nuclear genome came from the Finnish Dorset Eve, her mitochondria came from the cytoplasm of the Scottish blackface Eve. Mitochondria carry their own genome, as we all know, it has its own DNA. And so with respect to the gene in mitochondria DNA, she is not the clone of the Finn Dorset parent. Now the golden rice technology. We all know what the golden rice is, also one of a GMO, that is the genetically modified organism of food. Golden rice is a variety of Oryza sativa, that is the scientific name of the rice, produced by the genetic engineering. Biofortification, as we all know, it is the creation of the plants that make or accumulate micronutrients. Means the plants give us extra nutrients, is known as biofortification. Main purpose is to provide provitamin A to third world developing countries where malnutrition is permanent or it is seen very usually. And vitamin A deficiency are common. But why is rice selected? Because it is a global staple food cultivated for over more than 10,000 years. Rice provides as much as 80% or more in daily caloric intake of 3 billion people, which is the half of the world's population. Other plants such as sweet potatoes have varieties that are rich, orange-fleshed or poor, that are white-fleshed, in pro-vitamin A. These are all having vitamin A, but still rice is a global staple food, so we select rice. Carrots were originally white or purple in 1600s. A Dutch horticulture mutated the carrot to produce the carotenes or symbolize the color of Dutch royal house, that is orange. That is why we get orange color carrots now in the market. Now, what are the advantages of the golden rice? Golden rice give more quantity because of the biofortification. They give vitamin A. It is easy distribution when released to the needy. Cheaper option to supply a vitamin A requirement compared to the other supplementary measures like medicines. Sustainable options, as once released for the common cultivation, can be cultivated every growing season by farmer saved seeds. Therefore, no need for yearly budgetary investment of the distribution. Now, what are the disadvantages? Health, it may cause allergies or fail to perform desired effect. Supply does not provide a substantial quantity as recommended by the daily intake. What does harm does it do to the environment? Loss of biodiversity, many become the gregarious weed and endanger the existence of natural rice plants. Genetic contamination of natural, global and staple food. And in culture, some of the people prefer to cultivate and eat only what is natural or according to their tradition. They do not, or due to their spiritual belief, they do not try new things like the golden rice. Thank you.